livestream. My name is Jamie Loftus. Is this too loud? This seems too loud. Okay. My name is Jamie Loftus, and welcome to the 20th Century American Theater portion of the livestream. I hope you've been enjoying all the wonderful music you've been hearing from really talented people who worked a long time on this. We're just going to consider this a bit of a change of pace, because here's, okay, so when someone tells you, hey, you got a half hour, when you're a musician and when you're a comedian, that's two very different things, you know, because one, if you're a musician, you can do something, you have a skill, right? You have a skill. And then if you're a comedian, you just, and there's no one to talk to, and it's just your boyfriend, and he's just there, and he's like, it's just different, and you're not making people feel things in the same way. I think whereas you've found in your night so far that people you've been like, oh, I feel good, I feel calmer, I feel relaxed. I think what you're gonna find in this next segment is more of a tense feeling, you know, because you just a half hour of singing, you know, I love music so much, but you can get some filler in there, you know what I mean? And so this is gonna be a little bit different. This is a pool party. Do we have a comment? You were just waving at me. Okay, I don't understand. Okay. So this is a pool party. You can't legally go outside, so I'm just wearing a bathing suit inside. Is it pandering? We don't know. Listen, I can't play an instrument, and so this is what we've got. Half hour, very different for me than it is for other people. Okay, you know, time is a construct, it's fine. This is how I'd act at a regular pool party, do you understand? So here's what we're gonna be doing today. We've got a lot. I think I just had a full panic attack and now I'm ready to just slow my speech pattern down and do something. Welcome to my living room. It's very hot in here. It's really hot and it smells like animals because animals live here. What we're gonna be doing today is not just a pool party. It's my favorite kind of pool party. It's a salute to the great American plays of the 20th century. These are all plays that I was assigned to read in high school and I did not read. So this is going to be exciting for me, as it inevitably will be for you. Do you know what fills a half hour of time? That's right, plays from the 20th century. Brilliant, galaxy brain, we did it. Time. Okay, so we have a lot of exciting plays to explore today, and I'm thrilled to have two of the greatest actors of all time that are in my home right now. And so we're socially distancing, right? And so I just wanted to show you really quickly, you know, some of us are at home alone. There's no one with us. We're discovering this new level of loneliness that we've never experienced. We're making online purchases, right? We're not feeling good. We're feeling bad. We feel like we're sinking into the floor, right? And then others are with other people. And it's just, if you're home alone, it's just as bad, if not worse. If you want to see the few precious relationships in your life just unravel in real time as you get so close to someone that you're just like, ugh, you know, it's just like that. So if you want that, but you have to be safe about it. Do you understand? You have to be safe. And so what I would, is this too close? I feel like I'm getting so close. Okay, so if you're with someone right now, I want to show you how to be sanitary and be socially distant while you're at my pool party. So if you have a partner or a loved one nearby, I just want you to just sanitize them and rub them down with consent, of course, but you gotta sanitize them before the show starts. So here I've got one of my many housemates here. Here's Cassandra, right? She's amazing. She's 24 years old. And so here's what you're going to want to do with, you can see we're close, but she's filthy. She's not clean, right? So you want to start the pool party by just sanitizing her down. So I've got some lavender sanitizer here, right? And you want to just turn their head 180 degrees so that it kind of surprises them when they feel that she goes, oh, you know, because she doesn't know what's happening to the friend, but I have consent and she trusts me. And, you know, her head is all the way around like an owl, and that's nice. For her. So this is feeling good, this is feeling safe, right? And then of course, you gotta get the sunblock. If you stand near a window, you're not safe. So you just, whoop, there you go, there's that. All right, Cassandra, let's, remember when you were listening to music, wasn't that fun? You liked that, didn't you? I bet you did. All right, so then here we have a sanitized, thrilled, happy partner. God bless you. Okay, and then finally, if you're going to continue watching the stream, you might want to just cover that person's eyes for the remainder. So now that we're safe, God bless you, Sunny, I think that we're just going to get to the main portion of the show, the respect for our great, boring white male authors from a while ago. So first, I want to, you know, this is America, it's falling apart, but we got to pay tribute, right? So without further ado, I'd like to, if you wouldn't mind standing, if you still have respect, you know, it doesn't matter. But if you'd like to stand, feel free. We're just going to do the national anthem really quick. And we have a great singer. I mean, you've seen some musicians tonight, but you haven't seen a musician like this. This is me in 2003, so check this shit out.
She's been accompanied by Sergeant Ehrlich of the United States Army. Our colors are being presented by the Brockton Police Color Guard.
Okay, so I don't know if you're feeling patriotic, but I sure am. I did that every summer for 10 years, and no one ever told me that I sucked shit at it. Can you believe that? Music is hard, man. I can't do what musicians do. Although, as you just saw, I fucking can. Okay, I'm having a panic attack. Let's move on. What we're going to be doing now is we're going to be moving into the theater portion. Isaac's doing some really incredible camera work. You have no idea. He's basically a live-in dolly. So what we're going to do next is we're going to paying tribute to three of our great American plays. And I don't want to reveal what they are right away. But I do want to introduce you to our wonderful, wonderful actors. They've been socially distancing, and then they just started coughing into each other's mouth. And hey, who am I to ruin a good time? So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to our actors. Their names are Logan and Melody. And they're, please clap, please applaud. Do you understand, again, like, I don't have songs to play, and so this is what I do. This is my life. Okay, why don't we have the actors introduce themselves? I think we should start with, is it Logan we should start with? Let's see.
Hello, everyone. Yes, okay. My name is Logan. I'm a classically trained Juilliard professional WHO cut my teeth off Broadway. Okay. Starring as the front half of the Horse in War Horse, then was later promoted to the back half.
Can you hear this?
I'm currently starring on Broadway as Stumpin' Into the Woods 2. The Woods are B.I. now.
Okay, let's hear from Melody. What do you got? What do you got? Melody.
Hello, thank you.
Oh, there
thank
you, go.
You. Stop cheering. My name is Melody. And I am a classically trained actor from London. WHO has starred in productions such as I Kill Princess Diana and Princess Diana is Secretly American. I am thrilled to be joining Jamie Loftus' 20th Century American Theatre Dance Party this year, and may as well die after IT ends because nothing is going to top this.
Okay, Melody, as you can see, is visiting us all the way from Australia. Isn't that neat? So yes, she boarded a plane. She came here just for this, and boy, are we bleeding viewers on this already. So here's the first play I'd like to introduce you to. I'm just gonna lean in here because I've got a little part. the first play that we're going to be performing for you today is a scene from Waiting for Godot. Now this one I have not seen, have not read, and feel mostly too stupid to understand. I understand when you okay. When I think of Waiting for Godot at the pool with my friends, as I do, I think this is probably a metaphor for something, but it's way out of my pay grade to know exactly what it is. But we're gonna give it a shot. This is the closing scene from Waiting for Godot, and this is my show, so I even gave myself a little part in it. So it's two people that are waiting for Godot. Logan's gonna be playing Vladimir. Is this play Russian? I actually didn't check if these plays are American. Melody is going to be playing the other one, Escargot. What is it? Escargot. And I'm going to be playing the boy messenger. So if you wouldn't mind, we're going to get started on Waiting for Godot. That's by Samuel Beckett, who is American, I think. Okay. Waiting for Godot by Logan, Melody, and of course, myself. I'm a multi-hyphenate. Okay, here we go. Okay, any second now. Okay, here we go.
Suffered. Am I sleeping now? Tomorrow, when I wake, or think I do? What shall I say of today? That with Estragon, my friend, at this place, until the fall of night, I waited for Godot. That Pozzo passed, with his carrier, and that he spoke to us, probably. But in all that, what proof will there be?
Okay.
You know nothing.
You're right.
He'll tell me about the blows he received, and I'll give him a carrot. Astride of a grave and a difficult berth. Down in the hole, lingeringly, the grave digger puts on the forceps. We have time to grow old. The air is full of our cries. But habit is a great deadener. At me too someone is looking. Of me too someone is saying. He is sleeping. He knows nothing. Let him sleep on. I can't go on. Course. What have I said?
He goes feverishly to and fro. Halts finally at extreme left. Broods. Enter boy right. That's me. Silence. Mr. Albert.
Your game, course. Do you not recognize me?
No, sir.
It wasn't you came yesterday.
No, sir.
This is your first time.
Yes, sir. Silence.
You have a message from Mr. Godot.
Yes, sir.
He won't come this evening.
No, sir. This is a good meaty part.
But he'll come tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Without fail.
Yes, sir. Silence. Dramatic.
Did you meet anyone?
No, sir.
Two others. He hesitates, men.
I didn't see anyone, sir.
What does he do? Mr. Godot, silence. Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Well?
He does nothing, sir. The metaphor.
How is your brother?
He's sick, sir.
Perhaps it was he came yesterday.
I don't know, sir.
Has he a beard, Mr. Godot?
Yes, sir.
Fair or, he hesitates, or black?
I think it's white, sir. We're talking about Godot's beard.
Christ have mercy on us.
Silence. What should I tell Godot, sir? Well?
Tell him. He hesitates, tell him you saw me in that. He hesitates that you saw me.
You advance, I recoil. You halt, I halt.
You're sure you saw me? You won't come and tell me tomorrow that you never saw me?
I don't say anything. Vladimir makes a sudden spring forward. I avoid him, and I exit, running. He's still here, though. Okay, now they're all back. He takes off his boots, but he doesn't have boots. Do you understand? Okay, now Melody's back.
What's wrong with you?
There you
Nothing.
Go.
I'm going.
So am I.
Was I long asleep?
I don't know.
Where shall we go?
Not far.
Oh yes, let's go far away from here.
We can't.
Why not?
We had to come back tomorrow.
What for?
To wait for Godot.
Ah, silence. He didn't come?
Number. No.
And now it's too late.
Yes, now it's night.
And if we dropped him, cause, if we dropped him?
He'd punish us. Silence. He looks at the tree. Everything's dead but the tree.
Looking at the tree, what is it?
It's a tree.
Yes, but what kind?
I don't know. A willow.
Why don't we hang ourselves?
With what?
You haven't got a bit of rope.
Number.
Then we can't.
Let's go.
Wait, there's my belt.
It's too short.
You could hang onto my legs.
And who'd hang onto mine?
True.
Show me all the same.
Okay, and then they go over and they set up the noose, but it's not working.
It might do in a pinch, but is it strong enough?
We'll soon see. Here.
Alright, they try it. It doesn't work. Oh, no.
You say we have to come back tomorrow?
Yes.
Then we can bring a good bit of rope.
Yes.
Did he?
Yes.
I can't go on like this.
That's what you think.
If we parted, that might be better for us.
We'll hang ourselves tomorrow, of course, unless Godot comes.
And if he comes?
We'll be safe.
And that's the end of the play. Now, I think, sound off in the comments if you understood what that meant.
Well, shall we go?
Okay.
Pull on your trousers.
Oh, sorry. That wasn't the end. That was pretty much the end. Here's the thing about waiting for Godot. You don't know who he is. He's a metaphor. And then before you know it, 2 hours of your life are gone and you're supposed to talk about it all the way home. But God only fucking knows what it means. I don't know. I bet Anthony Hopkins has been in it. What do we think? Has anyone commented anything, Isaac?
People are saying Alfred Molina is the understudy.
Yeah, he wouldn't get the main part. And that's just an injustice. I don't think he would get the main part. I saw him in a play called The Father. I don't know what the fuck was going on there. But it wasn't Godot, okay? It wasn't a play that people knew. I'd like to move ahead to, I think it's not actually a 20th century play. It's a 21st century play. But I think you can feel the 20th century influences really strongly in this one. This is by a playwright named Tommy Wiseau, and it might be one that you've actually seen before. This is a more popular play to the point where it's actually been broadcast in theaters for years and years. So what you're going to be seeing in this play is, it's another metaphor, it's another thinker, no one's cracked it yet, but it's in there, you know what I mean? So what we've got in this one, we have Logan playing the part of Johnny, the romantic lead, and one who can do no wrong. We have Melody playing the part of Lisa, and she's, what you have to know about Lisa is she is not nice, okay? She is not a nice lady. She seems like she's nice, but then guess what? She isn't, okay? And then I'm gonna be there just at the beginning. This is so close. Okay, just at the beginning. And I'm gonna be playing the part of Michelle, Lisa's friend. And based on how Michelle is written, you have to think that is something she was born to do, because it's the only thing we know about her. Okay, so without further ado, we skipped over the crucible, so thank your lucky fucking stars for that, okay? We skipped from the crucible to the room. The crucible, I swear to God, is so boring. It's so boring. I wanted to show you Death of a Salesman, but that's like too like taking your own life in a row. You're like, what is wrong with these men? They're so upset. They have no idea how good they have it. We're like locked in our houses, right? But anyways, they were upset. Something about capitalism, I'm not sure. Sonny, get the fuck out of here, man. Sonny, I'm sorry, that was a mirage. If you can see that, you're very sick and you should probably see a doctor, because you can only see this. Is anyone seeing this? If you can see this thing, it's a metaphor and it's an omen, and you're very, very sick. Okay, we're gonna do the room, and then we're gonna sing the national anthem, and then we're gonna get out of here. So without further ado, here's Logan and Melody in the room. Fuck. Okay.
I heard you. What secret?
It's between us women.
Hi, Johnny.
Did you get a new dress?
Well, I guess. I better be going. I guess I'll just talk to you guys later.
Excuse me.
Lisa, remember what I told you.
What's she talking about?
It's girl talk. I just told you that.
I never hid you. You shouldn't have any secrets from me. I'm your future husband.
You sure about that? Maybe I'll change my mind.
Don't talk like that. What do you mean?
What do you think? Women change their minds all the time.
Hey, ha ha ha. You must be kidding, aren't you?
Look, I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to go upstairs and wash up and go to bed.
Shoving Lisa down onto the couch. How dare you talk to me like that? You should tell me everything.
I have talk right now.
Why, Lisa? Why, Lisa? Please talk to me. Please. You're part of my life. You are everything. I could not go on without you. Lisa.
You're scaring me.
You're lying. I never hid you. You are tearing me apart, Lisa.
Why are you so hysterical?
Do you understand life? Do you?
Don't worry about it. Everything will be alright.
You drive me crazy.
Good night, Johnny.
Don't worry about it. I still love you. Good night, Lisa.
And scene. And so I think that if we're going to analyze this, and we should, I think that we can draw a direct line from waiting for Godot to the room, because guess what? No, actually, I was going to say they both take places in rooms, but that's actually not true of either of them. I don't know why the room is called the room, and I'm pretty sure waiting for Godot takes place outside. We're going to finish with a dance, if we could get back into the room. Thank you so much to Logan and to Melody. They'll be taking their bows during the dance portion. How many people are watching at this point? 14?
87. It's been steady the whole time.
You guys are wild for this one. Okay. We're going to finish strong, and we're going to finish with a dance. A dance of passion, a dance of love, and I think the logical conclusion of American theater itself. Now, we've seen some more serious stuff, we've seen some more campy stuff, but what we haven't covered in the American theater canon is music. And something that has always meant a lot to me in my life in Boston and in my life with Alston Pudding is Shrek the Musical. It's a musical that came out in spite of everything. Starts some of Broadway's, brightest stars. We're talking your Sutton Fosters. We're talking your Brian D'Arcy James. People who had no right to be in something like this. But this is the Act One closer, and the cast and I are going to take their bows. If you can see this again, I have to remind you, you're very sick and you need to see a doctor, and fast. All right, to close out the night, here is Shrek the Musical, Build a Wall. All right, where's the ribbon dancer? Okay, I know where it is.
I'm gonna build me a wall. I'll make it 10 feet high. Bye-bye.
Everyone at home, applaud for the mirage. If my arms are empty, you're in great health and nothing's wrong. All right, so I take a bow. All right, get out of here.
I'm gonna build me a wall. I'm gonna disappear.
All right, we're gonna say goodbye to Cassandra next. So if you want to just sing. Oh, wow, she's so beautiful. Look at her. She's just gonna... Thank you so much. Thank you so much. She's actually really sticky and wet because of all the... Oh, what is this? I don't know. Look at it. We can get a close-up on what's her on. What is this? What is this? This isn't for people. All right, we're gonna... Oh, smells weird. All right. All right. All right. And finally, of course, we have to say goodnight to our actors. And we're gonna do it in order of importance. So first, we're gonna have someone who did their best tonight. Here's Logan. Right? He's pretty good. He's been around the block a couple times. But you know, he's nepotism. He's someone's nephew. Sorry. But our true ingenue tonight, in spite of the fact that we couldn't really control her legs, is Melody. She's got a great fit, she's got a great attitude, and she's a star in the making. So, there we go. Good for Melody. Honestly, this was her debut,
And I think she did a wonderful job. Great job, truly. You've got a big future. And now she's doing the Black Swan, where she says, I was perfect. I was so good at being Lisa that now I can just go away. And she just went away. Okay. I want to shout out myself when I'm 10 years old in 2003. All right? It was a beautiful performance, and the Bronson Rocks should have me back anytime. And thank you. I hope that you don't hold what I did against the fundraiser. Thank you to Isaac, who's been a hold. He had to remind me, and I'm going to pay for this. Thank you to Isaac, and thank you to you, everyone, who's hung in there. I hope you now understand what a half hour can feel like. Good night. How do we stop? It worked?
Do it.
Oh no. Oh no. Did it stop?